Wonder if the gods are watching me.
Ah, a fellow wanderer. Forgive the aroma.
You catch a waft of something foul, metallic, and sickly sweet.
Powdered iron vine. Most monsters will think twice before making a meal of me. An old hunter's trick. If you can't mask your scent, spoil it. Today, the same as you, a humble supplicant, come to bargain with the lady of this house. That is why you came to her lair, I take it, to bargain. A more innocent name than some I could call her, but it is what she is that ought to concern you. Her kind have hidden among us since the first darkness. And their knowledge is matched only by their spite. Know how to ask, and they'll share that knowledge. If you're fool enough to pay their price. A powerful friend, a terrible foe. That I cannot decide for you. For my part, I need her knowledge. The thing I hunt has gone to ground. If she can tell me how to flush him out, I'll pay whatever price she asks. Truth is like a blade, my friend. We can arm ourselves with it, or just as easily find it pressed against our throat. I would not put you in danger. This duty is mine alone. But for such an offer, an answer at least is owed. I hunt a vampire spawn called Astarion. I'm bound to bring him back to Baldur's Gate, alive. Though I cannot swear to his condition once my tribe are done with him. Is he known to you?
My people were recently attacked in the night. Our camp set upon by a band of vampire spawn. In the chaos of battle, one of them stole away with our children. And we've been searching for them ever since. We believe this Astarion knows exactly what happened that night and where to find our little ones. If captured, my people will make him talk. So I ask again, is he known to you?
I see. Your loyalty is admirable, but misplaced. His kind have charm beyond our mortal means to resist. I can show you who he truly is, if you will just tell me where to find him. Astarion has quite the friend in you. I'll make sure he knows that. At the end.
Solidarity keeps the troop together.
Let's hope it doesn't come back to bite me later. Goes nothing.
I don't want a crumb left on that plate, girl.
Auntie Ethel, please. One more bite and this pie is gonna come back up to say hello.
Don't make me get the wooden spoon. You're eating for two, so get to it. If it isn't the cheekiest pup of them all, you'd best have one hells of an apology for me, young man. Another bard who thinks humor is the same as talent. Cute. You know, I was going to give you a swift kick up the arse and show you the door. But I think you and I could have a bit of fun together. Gods grant me patience. Eat up, Mayrina. I won't say it again. Keep your own little nose in your own little dish, Petal. I don't like busybodies. Besides, you have bigger problems. That wriggler swimming in your brain juice is a bit of an inconvenience, isn't it? I told you that girl is none of your business. Keep that hole under your nose shut.
She's a pregnant lady in distress. We can't just stand by and pretend she's not here.
I'll talk about your wriggler, and that's it. Last warning. You want to play the hero so badly? Fine. Let's make this interesting.
Favors the fearless. might will prevail.
Dolla!
Another fight. Let's go. Fall by my hand.
Bye-bye, lovelies.
I can't have gone far.
Always room for more? Never wanted the easy path. Thank you. Something good here, I hope.
Go ahead. I'm listening.
Ah, yes. Karsus. Karsus was perhaps the most powerful wizard that ever lived. The child who would be a god, the elves called him. And he tried. With a spell of his own devising, he endeavored to usurp in one fell swoop the power of the goddess of magic. Mistril, she was called then. Imagine what it must have felt like to be a god, to know yourself, to be untouchable, to be mistaken. As Karsus aimed his spell at her, she began to unravel, and with her, the entire weave. Too late did he realize what he had unleashed. It would have been the end of everything had not Mistral sacrificed herself. The goddess of magic is all magic. By dying, the entire weave was lost, and the spell that challenged a god failed. It was the end of Mistral, the end of Karsus, and the end of an entire civilization. As the child who would be a god was turned to stone, his empire came crashing down around him. The floating cities of Netheril were no more, an event that came to be known as Karsus's folly. For a spell, Mistral was reborn as Mistra. Upon her return, the weave returned with her. Now, so many centuries later, I try to follow in the footsteps of Karsus. Not to destroy Mistra, but to prove my love for her. I tried to control only a fraction of the magic that was unleashed that fateful day. I merely sought to return one tiny diamond to an imperfect crown. Gale's folly, one might call it. History. Repetition. It's the way things go. If it should ever come to that, if I ever know I am no longer able to stop it, I will do anything I can to ensure no one but me pays for my mistakes. I will find the remotest place on the surface of Faerun, or perhaps far below in the depths of the Underdark. I will await that death, alone. I promise I will not betray your trust. You kept me by your side despite the menace that I am. If worst comes to worst, I will be long gone before the curtain falls.
fetid smell assaults your nostrils. Dead flesh lies below. A great deal of it. The warm rush of power flows through you. You feel stronger, faster, better.
Well, well, well.
Fetid smell assaults your the warm rush.
Which way to the nearest library?
Fetid smell the warm rush.
Where am I needed?
Fetid smell as the warm.
What are they?
Making me sweat.
Your desire?
The pride of the gate.
Can't give up now. Another step forward. Oh, cursed to put my hands on everything.
Don't look. Don't.
I can't.
You are as thick as they come, sweetness. This is my personal playhouse, and you don't have an invite. Get out! Wriggler eaten your brain already? Leave. Or you'll end up in tonight's stew. You'll go nicely with Mayrina. She's already marinating.
Closer to the mirror, a pale face appears, contorted in fear. Fists slam against the mirror's surface again and again.
Look. Don't
see the shadowed outline of a figure.
Stop. Please. Please.
You see the shadowed outline.
Don't look. Don't.
She wished for the mind of a genius. Dear, wish never to lay eyes on her family again. My dearest Ephryn, he begged me to halt the deadly disease that ravaged him. My gentle Lauren.
Don't!
He wished to know what was to come.
You feel crushing waves of fear as the presence within the door recoils. It can't let people through, not again. Images flash. A man cowering, a bag open at his feet. Gold coins spilling onto the floor. His cries for mercy are cut short as the hag slices into him, dismembering him painstakingly, limb by limb. She cackles, the man's remaining flesh twisted and contorted, becoming the twisted surface of the door before you. Flee, you feel it cry. A scene appears in your mind. Two paladins and a cleric marching through the door, shrouded in the glow of the divine. Weapons brandished, they charge into the hag's lair. Screams of terror pierce the air.
You let them in? Naughty. That's a decade for each. You're mine for 30 more years, Petal.
You see an image of blue skies and sunshine as the door shudders a warning. Run. You see the hag. She walks through the door, its form shimmering. The lightest touch of hope brushes your mind as the presence within retreats.
Please! Please! No! No! Don't look! Mustn't look! Mustn't see! I see it! I see what's to come! Me! Dead! Dead! Flesh rotten, bone shining! No future. Bone splitting, knife twisting, skull screaming future! Gods, don't hurt me! Oh, please, 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 please! Trick! They're the monster! Monster! For mind dripping! Flesh peeling! Mind flayer! No! No! Mind flayer! Get away! Get away!
No intention of letting that happen.
Still me.
Away!
Even after everything.
Feel the barest hint of life from within the door,
Please! Please!
See the shadowed outline.
Don't look. Stop.
See the shadowed outline of...
Please. Please!
A thief who tried to steal from Auntie. Now the good little pet guards my home.
Don't look. Don't look. Don't!
Hello, Petal. My, my. The mask suits you. Just relax. See the world with fresh eyes. And let your dear old Auntie Ethel look after you.
You.
Yes, I have you now, Petal. Don't worry. Auntie is going to take good care of you.
Shit. This doesn't seem good.
It's the mask. Get that thing off.
You're mine now, precious.
Now, Petal. stop. Please. Please!
Hello, Emily.
Don't look. Don't.
Stench of rot is a.
Yeah. What?
Stop.
They are through the oculus.
Please. Away. Away. Stop! Please! Please! Away! Away!
A thief who tried to steal from Auntie. Now
don't.
The good little pet guards my home.
Feel the barest hint of life from within the door.
Please! Please! Don't look,
my dearest Catherine. He begged me to halt the deadly disease that ravaged.
Stop, please, please. Don't look. Don't!
That's for the wicked, I see.
Stop! Please! Please! Away!
You feel the barest hint of life from within.
Don't look.
Have to keep going.
blood follows me everywhere. Path.
Yes.
Fuck!
want it!
I won't hurt them.
Die.
chances.
Here. Got it.
A tale for the ages. The lesson is death. No holding back. Thank you.
seek and you shall find me.
That'll have to do.
What now?
Careful not to trigger that thing.
Light on my feet.
Easy. This place is hungry for blood.
Let me work my magic.
Their worst nightmare.
Eat this!
No time to rest.
Charmed, I'm sure.
Surprise.
May it please, Mistra.
Trap. So much for a warm welcome.
If not over, then through.
Cooking.
At the ready. Sharp as ever. Ah, excellent choice.
Defender of the people.
Never a dull moment. I've a lot on my mind and, well...
There! In the cage!
One day I'll catch a break.
Trap. Be cautious.
You come to my home, interfere in my business, and now have the gall to face me in the heart of my lair! You petulant bollocks! I'll rip your spine out your asshole! I'll use your blood to spice my stew! I'll keep you alive until I've sucked the marrow from your bones! Then I'll bring you back and do it all over again.
Just get out of here, please.
You want the girl so bad. Fine.
Up.
dogs.
This is my time. For mercy.
Step by step. Two steps at a time.
I got this.
In position.
Very well. Let's get this over with.
One can't always be a gentleman.
Torment!
worm in a blink.
No choice but to keep going.
Jimmy on the go.
Deep and move. Try me.
Ignis!
The blade will not bend.
Wait! Oh, wait just a tick!
Killing me is a waste of time. I'll find a way to return. Always have, always will. But it's unpleasant. So how about we be civilized about this, I have something you want.
You wound me, sweetie. My offer will put that little pact of yours to shame. Let me leave with the girl, and I'll give you power. You want to be stronger, tougher, smarter? Done. Anything is possible.
Just let me keep the girl and her babe.
It's your choice, sweetness. I'll not soon forget this sweetness. You have my word.
But the deal. What about my husband? What happens to him?
Deal's off, you dumb cow. And you have him to thank for it. Not that it matters. I'll find another just as plump and ripe. I can set up shop elsewhere. People always need lotions and potions. If I ever see you again, you'll have a tentacle for a tongue. Bye-bye, Petal.
You bastard! You ruined it! You ruined everything! Ethel was going to bring my husband back. Back from the dead. And now I'll never see him again. Because of you! This... just a bit longer and my child would have been born! And all this would have been over. Don't judge me. I have nothing. My baby would have been raised in rags. Auntie Ethel promised to give this child a good life. Teach them magic, even. More than I could have done. I always wanted to be a mother. I just never thought I'd do it alone. Now I'll have to drag Connor's coffin all the way home. It's the only way this child will ever meet their father. I hope you're happy.
Minster's not around, so it might as well. My pleasure.
I've got a long road ahead. Time to press ahead.
Give it a shot.